In this video, we're going to look at ZFS snapshots. I'm going to create a new ZFS pool with the command sudo zpool create my zpool /dev/sdb. And I'm going to update the owner to Michael with the command sudo chown michael my zpool. Now that we have the zpool created, I will check to see if any snapshots exist for this zpool with the command zpool get list snapshots my zpool. And we see that ZFS is telling us that snapshots are not turned on for my zpool. It shows the value equals off. I'm going to set list snapshots on with the command sudo zpool set list snapshots equals on for my zpool. Now when I get the list snapshots, we see the value is set to on. We create the snapshot with the command zfs snapshot. Then we give it the zfs file name. In this case, it is my zpool. Then we add an at symbol and we'll give it a snapshot name. First snapshot. Pressing enter and our snapshot is taken. We can see the snapshot we just took with the command zfs list. And we see the snapshot right under the zpool. If we want to see just the snapshots, we can type zfs list-t for type and then snapshot, and we see only the snapshots. If we have multiple Z pools and we only want to see the one Z pool, we can add the Z pool name after it, my Z pool. And if we want to only see the name, we'll say snapshot dash O name, comma, and then the Z pool name. And there we see the Z pool snapshot name. And we see that new snapshot is taking up 0 bytes of storage because at the moment it is the same as the my zpool ZFS zpool. I'm going to cd into my zpool and I'm going to paste in a command to create a file. Let's cat out that file I just created. And we see that it's test file one and it has test file one inside. I'm going to take a snapshot, sudo zfs snapshot, and it's going to be for my zpool. And then the name I'll give it is test file one. So we'll know that this snapshot has test file one in it. Oh, and if we want to see the list of snapshots, we can check that with ls-lh my zpool.zfs/snapshot. So we've got our snapshot test file one. I'm going to remove test file one.txt and we'll check that with ls-lh. It's gone. And now I'm going to roll back to the most recent snapshot to get back test file one with the command zfs rollback my zpool at test file one. And typing ll shows the file is back. Catting out that file shows it does have the right data inside that file. Now I'm going to remove test file one again, and I'm going to paste in the command to create a test file two. Let's cat out test file two, and we see it's there. And now I'll take a snapshot, and we'll call this test file two. And I'll paste in another command to create test file three. And I'll create a third snapshot. Now I'm going to list out my snapshots with zfs list-t snapshots. And I typed zfs list-t snapshots with an S but we need it without the S. Even though we're looking for multiple snapshots, the command is snapshot. So we see we've got four snapshots out there, our first snapshot, and then the three test file snapshots. I want to return to the snapshot with test file one in it. So I will type in sudo zfs rollback my zpool at test file one. And we get the message cannot roll back to more than the most recent snapshot. Use dash r to force deletion of the following snapshots. And then it lists our two snapshots, test file two and test file three. In this case, I'm okay deleting the two other snapshots. So I will type sudo zfs rollback dash r my zpool at test file one. Actually, before I roll back, let's see what's in this directory with ls-lh. And we see test files 2 and 3. Now I'll run the rollback and typing ls-lh again shows us that test files 2 and 3 are now gone and test file 1 is back. And catting that out shows that it is the data that was in file test file one. Typing zfs list-t snapshot shows that snapshots test file two and test file three were both deleted. So zfs had to delete them to make test file one the most recent snapshot because it can only restore the most recent snapshot. There is a way to get data off an older snapshot, and we will talk about that in the next video. Let's create some datasets in our zpool with the command sudo zfs create my zpool project one. And I'll create another one. We'll call this one dataset one. And then I'm going to update the owner of both of these, sudo chown michael dot my zpool project one and dataset one. Let's add test file two into project one with the command echo test file two into my zpool project one test file two.txt. And let's add test file three into the dataset one directory with the command echo test file 3 into my zpool dataset 1. Now I'll take a snapshot of project 1 with the command sudo zfs snapshot my zpool project 1 at snap 1. And let's check out our snapshots with zfs list-t snapshot. There we see our new dataset project one snapshot, snap one, just as we expected. Now, if I want to take a snapshot of the zpool and all the datasets inside that zpool all at the same time, we can do that by taking a zpool snapshot with a dash r for recursively take snapshots. Sudo zfs snapshot dash r my zpool at, and I will call this r snap one. And we can list these out with zfs list-t snapshot. And we see that there are now three snapshots that were made called r snap one. One for the zpool, my zpool. One for the dataset, dataset one. And one for the dataset project one. In the next video, we're going to look at ZFS clone for snapshots for the Linux command line.